Probably the two best you can use in your classroom is art and music. Okay, make sure those are part of your class. What's another fifth C? Computer, technology. Okay, that's probably very important as well. But that's not for language class right now.
We'll save that for later.
So why is this important? Why is this important? Is it important? It's important for three big reasons. One, the good input, bad output students. Or you can say the good classroom student, bad real world student. So this student, she does well on the test. She listens very well. She does the multiple choice perfectly. You think, wow, she's a great student. Then she goes outside into the real world and she can't use her language. She doesn't have the skills. Okay, she's good at studying language, but she can't use language. Okay, so we have to help those students. Two, it's a shrinking world. Okay, I'm coming from the States. I live in Korea. We're all here together in Phnom Penh. It's a shrinking world. We're gonna have to work together more. And three, your students are gonna have jobs one day. In what century? 21st century, right? Yeah. 21st century. Funny because it's 27. So, I want to leave on this. What can you do as a teacher? How can you design your lessons to get these skills out? There are five things you can do. Okay, let your students lead the class. There's teacher-centered, there's student-centered, but there's also student-led. So at the beginning of your class, this is a great time for your students to decide what are they interested in, what do they want to talk about. So if your lesson is on seasons, before you start the book, ask the kids what they like. What's your favorite season? What do you like to do? What season do you not like? What do you want to talk about with seasons? Let them lead the class a little bit. Inquiry-based, what does that mean? Push your kids to ask questions. Make them thirsty for more knowledge, okay? A great thing you can do with inquiry-based is called KWL. Does anyone know this?
No.
What do you know? So if we're going to read a story, what do you know about seasons? What do you want to know? So they ask questions. Well, I want to know what seasons do people in Wisconsin have? I want to know what's the coldest season? And then L is, what did you learn? So this is kind of before reading, making predictions, or asking questions, and then after reading. Okay. So that's about inquiry based. Encourage collaboration. Design your activities so they're working as a team or as a group. Maybe do projects, information gaps. There's lots of things you can do. Critical thinking skills. Make them think about what they're reading or what they're learning. What's the most important question you can ask to get more information? Starts with the W's, three letters. Why? Ask your kids why. Teacher, I don't want to do this. Why? I'm tired. Why? I didn't sleep a lot last night. Why? I was playing a video game. Why? It's cool. Why? I like the graphic. Ask why. Sometimes you have kids that ask you why. I say, stop talking. Shh. The reason why is because it's a hard question. And always, always encourage creativity. never punish creativity. Sometimes your kids will say the wrong answers, or they'll do it incorrectly, but encourage creativity, okay? So I am going to, are there any questions on 21st century skills? These are things you can begin to build in any classroom, even phonics. Okay, so during our activities, maybe not this one, but we definitely did collaboration. We did some critical thinking and we did some creativity, okay, with the drawings and the helping. So I want to end there. I want you guys to have a better understanding what phonics is and how you can teach it, and maybe how you can have fun with it. I also want you to have an understanding of what we can offer, you know, online, our platform, the app. And now I hope you just have a kind of an introductory idea of 21st century skills, which are, what are the four C's? Communication, collaboration, critical thinking, and creativity. Okay? Are there any questions? I want to thank you very much for your time today. I know you guys are all very busy. I know teachers have lots of work to do. I hope this was helpful, and you guys were really a fun group of teachers. So thank you very much for your time today.